Hey there guys, Paul here from theengineeringmindset.com. In this video, we're going to be looking at how to control a light fitting with two switches. This is very useful, for example, when placing a light switch at the top and bottom of a set of stairs, or at different doors in a room. We're going to look at two common ways to do this, as well as some different variations on the second version. Now, the color of the cables varies around the world according to different standards. I'm going to be using the European color code for this video, but you should check your local regulations. I just want to remind you that working with electricity is dangerous. We're covering just the theory in this video, so please do not undertake any electrical work unless you are qualified and competent. So, to control a light with two switches, we of course need two switches which have three terminals on the back. I'll leave some links in the video description down below for where to buy these switches online very cheaply. The name for these type of switches is different depending on where in the world you are. The US and North America call these three-way switches, but the EU calls these two-way switches. The switch can only be flipped one of two ways, either up or down. But if we look at the back of the switch, then we'll see there are three terminals, and that means there's four ways for electricity to flow through the switch. These will all depend on how the switch is wired. One terminal is called the common, and then we have a terminal called line 1 and another terminal called line 2. Let's say we want to control this light fitting using two switches. I'll flip them over so you can see how this would work. I'll also just rotate these to make the drawing a little easier to understand. So we have the electricity coming in from the consumer unit and feeding the light fitting. We therefore take the live wire and divert this into the common terminal of switch 1. We run another wire from the common terminal of switch 2 and connect this to the lamp. We now need to connect the two switches, so we connect terminal L1 of switch 1 with terminal L2 of switch 2. We need to place a brown sleeve at each end of this wire to warn that it is intermittently live. We then run another wire from terminal L2 of switch 1 and connect this to terminal L1 of switch 2, again placing a brown sleeve to indicate that this can be live. At the moment, the electricity can make it through switch 1 and into switch 2, but the circuit is broken at switch 2. If we then flip the switch, the circuit is complete, so electricity runs through the entire circuit and the lamp lights up. If we then flip switch 1, the circuit is broken again, so the lamp turns off. But electricity still flows to switch 2 where the circuit is broken. We could flip switch 1 again to complete the circuit, or we can flip switch 2 and the circuit is also complete. So we can therefore flip either switch 1 or switch 2 to make or break the circuit and thus control the light fitting with two switches. The second common way to control a light with two switches is to convert a one-way switch into a two-way. Again, we need two switches and you need to check the back to ensure that they have three terminals on each. If your one-way switch only has two terminals, then you need to replace this. So we cut the live wire feeding the lamp and run this into terminal L1 of switch 1. We then run a grey wire from terminal L1 of switch 1 to terminal L2 of switch 2. We need to place a brown sleeve at either end to warn that this is intermittently live. We run a brown wire between the two common terminals of both switches. Then we run a black wire from terminal L2 of switch 1 to terminal L1 of switch 2. Again, we need to place a brown sleeve at each end to warn that this is intermittently live. Lastly, to complete the circuit, we connect terminal L2 back to the supply for the light fitting. Again, using a brown sleeve to warn that it is intermittently live. The electricity can now flow and it will pass through switch 1 and into switch 2 where the circuit is broken. If we flip switch 2, we complete the circuit so the electricity can flow through the common and out into the lamp. If we flip switch 1, we break the circuit to the light fitting so the lamp turns off. If we then flip switch 2, we make the circuit again, electricity will flow to the light fitting. So the alternative ways work almost identically to the conversion we just saw, but in this method we run the live to L2 of switch 1. Then we run a brown cable from L2 of switch 1 over to L1 of switch 2. Then we run the grey wire from L2 of switch 2 over to L1 of switch 1. We need to place a brown sleeve at each end to warn that this is intermittently live. Then we run a black wire between both commons of both switches. Again, we need to place a brown sleeve at each end. Finally, we connect the blue wire from L1 of switch 1 back to the light fitting. Again, placing a brown sleeve at each end. So to start with, the circuit is broken, so electricity passes through switch 1 and into switch 2, but it reaches a dead end. If we then flip switch 1, we complete the circuit and electricity can flow through switch 1 and into switch 2, then back to switch 1 and up into the lamp. If we flip switch 2, we break the circuit, electricity just flows between the two switches and doesn't reach the light. If we flip switch 1, then electricity will flow to switch 1 and over into switch 2, across the switch and back over to switch 1, where it can flow to the light fitting. On the third variation, I won't animate the lines being connected for this one as you get the idea, but we connect the live to L1 of switch 1, then we run a brown wire between L1 of switch 1 to L1 of switch 2, then we run a grey wire between L2 of switch 2 and L2 of switch 1, then we run the black wire between the two commons, and finally we connect the blue wire between L2 of switch 1 and then the lamp. Remember to add a brown sleeve at all the cables to warn that they are intermittently live. The fourth variation is very similar to the last one, except that the black wire is connected between the two L1s of both switches, and the brown wire is connected across the two commons. Again, remembering to place a brown sleeve on the wires to indicate that they are intermittently live. Okay guys, that's it for this video, but to continue your learning, just click on one of the videos on screen now and I'll catch you there for the next lesson. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and of course, check out theengineeringmindset.com.